What it is, what's up you guys? We're doing a wig video today. I look really bummy. I look like I just woke up because I did just wake up. I am wearing my faja as well. I'm officially 2 months post-op. We are going to be doing a wig install today, which I do literally all the fucking time. I feel like you guys are probably sick of it by now, but if you're still rocking with me and you're still watching my wig videos, then... So the wig we're working with today is from Bisho Hair. It looks like this. This is the box. I'm gonna open it for you guys. We're doing blonde today. I love blonde hair. I love working with 613 hair, especially because it's the easiest to dye and to work with. And I love dyeing wigs, guys. It's one of like my favorite hobbies. I do it all the fucking time. Here's their little card. Here is all their socials. They also sent me a wig cap. Much appreciated. I never have enough wig caps. I run through them like crazy. So here is the hair. I did get it in 20 inches because I like long hair, but I don't like it too long because I'm so tiny. First comes out of the pack. This is what it looks like. So as you can see, 20 inches I think for me is pretty long. I've done like 26 inches before and I was like, bitch, like this is too much. I went with the 20 inches, which I think is perfect. The hairline looks really good. It looks like it's pre-plucked. Look at that. Look at that. And then this is the inside right here with the clips and stuff. So what we are doing with this wig, oh, it's really soft. It's really soft, it's pre-plucked, and the length is perfect. It's just chef's kiss. So far, 10 out of 10. What we are going to be doing with this wig is I want it to stay blonde. I never liked the yellowness of 613 hair, so I'm going to tone it. I have these toners, and these are just random toners that I had in my house. My apartment is full of hair supplies because me and my two roommates, we all like dye hair all day long. Like they dye their hair, I dye my wigs. So we're just like, it's literally like a beauty supply in the bathroom, like for real. I have these Wella toners. I just picked random shades. I got one in pale beige blonde, lightest beige blonde, and then this one is lightest ash blonde. I think three of these little jars should be enough for this entire hair, but we will see. So I'm gonna be coloring the wig, installing it. I want to do a cute hairstyle, like a little like updo. Like I seen Saweetie do this hair. I'll like put a picture right here, but she did like a cute little updo with like a long blonde wig. So I kind of want to do that today and just see how it goes. Okay baby, so we are on the floor now. Got my wig. So to tone this wig, I'm going to take these three different toners, put them in this little plastic bowl, and I'm gonna use this 30 volume developer. And I'm only using 30 because this is all we have right now. It doesn't really make a difference because we're not using bleach, so if you have 20 that would work also. So I started off with just the two bottles of the toner, and you want to do equal parts developer to the toner. So I ran out of the first bottle, but luckily I had a second bottle. So then you just mix it up really well, and then you start applying it to the wig. You really want to apply it all over and get it like as evenly as possible. So this is how it looked when it was all evenly coated. So then I washed out all the product, and I do use shampoo and conditioner because you want to make sure the wig stays nice and soft. And then we're just gonna blow dry it. So now we can begin the install process. So we are going to take our hair down, part it down the middle, and we are gonna start braiding it back. You know, the same as usual, guys. You want that hair to be out of your way and not peek out under the blonde. So we're just trying to braid our hair as tight as possible, getting all the baby hairs out the way, get the sideburns out. So then we're going to take our Eco Styler and our edge brush and lay it down some more, and then just spray it with some Got to Be Ultra Glue to make sure it's really not going to go anywhere. So then you want to just pin your braids back with some bobby pins and tuck it all under the wig cap. We're gonna take our Got to Be Free Spray again and just spray around the hairline and then blow dry it. And we're gonna go in again with a second layer of that and blow dry it again. So overall, this process takes maybe like 10-15 minutes. So then we're gonna cut off the wig cap
the band of the wig cap, so it just leaves you with a perfectly bald peanut. Don't forget to cut your ears out too, guys. So last time I put foundation on my wig cap and I used liquid foundation, and people were telling me I should do powder instead. So I tried with the powder this time, and here I am putting the wig on and trying it on and seeing how the hairline fits. Their hairline was kind of wonky, like, not gonna lie, it didn't really fit my particular hairline. I got like the egg shape going on and it was giving me like the square shape, you know. So whatever, we're gonna proceed anyway. I'm using the Ghost Bond waterproof glue. And this is the one I always use. It's tried and true. I use it all the time. It works really well. So I'm just putting a layer of that around the hairline. And then we are going to start laying the wig down. So I always hold it down on the sideburns the longest, because I feel like those are the trickiest and they never want to lay down for some reason. So I started using a razor to razor off the lace. And then I was like, yeah, this is not fucking working. So then I grabbed the scissor and just did it the way I usually do it. I always use a scissor. The razor just freaks me out. I feel like I'm gonna slice my forehead open. So I had to really cut my ears out because I don't know if this wig was too big for me or too small. Like, it just didn't align well with my hairline and my ears and everything. So I had to cut off like a big chunk off the side just so my ears could like poke through. But yeah, here I am just cutting off the rest of the lace. So you want to get it as close to the hairline as possible. I don't like leaving a lot of lace out, really. I know some people do and it's easier for them to lay it down, but I don't. And here I am cutting around the ear. This part is really tricky because you don't want to cut like too much of the hair off and have like a bald spot in the wig. So yeah.
First of all, I really love this texture. Like, I love like the wavy texture the wigs get when they're wet. But I don't know, maybe I could do like a front like bang, a hairstyle like this. That's kind of cute, and that way like it kind of like hides like the hairline, you know, the lace a little bit, you know. And then do like a half updo like that. I don't know, should we do that, guys? Oh my god, my braid fell in the back, girl. I'm a whole mess. Hold on, I'll come right back. Okay, baby, so I brushed the hair out. It's still kind of wet, but I think it'll be dry by the time we start straightening it. So we're gonna start working on the updo. Let's try to do the updo. Let's see how it would work. So right now I'm just trying to like part the hair, get a cute part going on. I do like the ponytail portion. I want it to be up like really high, so it would have to be like up here. That's kind of cute, actually. I think we should do this. Okay, don't know why this ponytail is mad flat. I feel like I should straighten the hair first. All right, let's start laying this down. I'm gonna lay down these front pieces and leave out just like a piece for the sideburn, kind of. So we gotta hide these sideburns, girl. They looking crazy. So I already have my flat iron heating up. I'm gonna just straighten these front pieces and we can start laying them down. And then we're gonna straighten the rest of the hair later, I think. I don't know. I don't really know what I'm doing. I'm kind of winging it. But I think that'll work out the best. Maybe I should have straightened it first, actually. But whatever. I think I'm saving time this way. So, guys, let's chat while I'm doing this. Because I feel like we don't chat enough. I feel like I always got some shit to tell you. I always got the tea. I went on a date the other day. It was cute. It was fun. But, like, I want to ask you guys a question. Is it okay if you go on a date and the guy doesn't offer to like buy you food? It's like every time I go on a date, I'm like, okay, let me not eat dinner because he's probably gonna take me out to eat. Like, you know what I mean? It's like, is it wrong for me to assume that we're gonna eat every time we go out? I just feel like dates involve food. Like, even if you're at a bar just like getting drinks, it's like, isn't it polite to at least offer to like buy food? I don't know. Maybe I'm wrong for that, but I wanted to ask you guys what you thought about that. Cause like, we went to an arcade. Oh my god, I hope like he doesn't watch this. But we went to an arcade. Like, you know, it was nice and all. He paid for everything, whatever. He paid for the drinks, he paid for the games. But like, I was so hungry. And like, I didn't want to be like a fatty and be like, okay, like, can we get food or whatever? Cause like, I don't think he, I don't know. I just didn't ask. I didn't feel like asking. Cause like, I didn't know what the vibes was. Also, it was like pretty late at night. Like, he picked me up at like 9 o'clock for the date. So it's like, okay, bitch, you haven't eaten all day. Like, you know, like I don't want to be that guy and be like, okay, it's 9 o'clock at night. Like, is we eating or what? Like, it was mad late already. So I just like let it rock. But I wanted to get you guys' opinion on it. And like, do you think you should eat out every time you go on a date, or only if it's like pre-established? Like, is it wrong to assume that you're gonna get food on a date? Like, comment down below, babies. Am I tweaking or what? My legs are falling asleep. Okay, this hair is actually taking me a lot longer than I thought it would. So, ow! Oh my god, I just burned my forehead. Oh my god, I burned my finger too. Ow, Jesus. Okay, I'm being reckless with this. I burned my forehead so bad. Oh my god, do you guys see it? Oh my goodness, it left a mark like right away. Be careful with this, y'all. Don't be reckless like me. We're gonna take out a piece here for the sideburn too. I kind of forgot. Okay, so we're gonna lay down the front portion. I'm just gonna take my gel and start slicking it down how I usually do. Take some gel and slick these parts down. Let's pull out some baby hairs, some thin pieces. We're gonna just razor it off. It's gonna be about this long. Then we're gonna take our edge brush, Eco Styler, try to finesse these shits. I think I have to cut them a little bit shorter. I'm about to just hit it with the Got To Be spray just in the front portion to make sure it's laid and it'll not get messed up while we're styling the rest of it. I'm just gonna lay it down real good, real flat. Sad I burned my forehead, that shit hurted. So I'm going to straighten the entire wig. It is still a little wet, so this might take a while. I'm gonna do it off camera just so I can charge my battery a little bit, but I will come back and finish up the top half when all of it is straightened, y'all. So I will be right back. Okay, baby, so I straightened the hair mostly. I'm not gonna show you guys the back of my head because it might look a little crazy, but from the front it looks cute, so that's all that matters. So now we are working on the ponytail. I brushed it out and I'm gonna straighten it really quickly. It's still a little wet, so it's just taking me forever. Oh my god, guys, I feel like I've been working on this hair all day. Like, literally since I woke up, I started working on this hair. It's just like taking forever, but we're almost done. We're almost there, guys. So it's looking really cute. I love it so far. So I like to brush through and then take the iron and follow the brush with it. Guys, I don't know about you, but whenever I do my hair, it makes me want to go out. Like, whenever I feel like a bad bitch, I'm like, people need to see me. Like, I need to be seen. I need to pop out. But I have nowhere to go today. It's literally, what day is today? I think it's like a Tuesday. Oh no, it's Thursday. It's Thursday, so I was like, where am I really gonna go? Also, it's like cloudy outside. It looks like it's gonna rain and stuff. But I do want to pop out just because I look so cute. I'm going to my mom's place tomorrow, so like, what a waste of a look, you know? Why am I going to waste a look going to visit my parents? Like, that's no fun. Okay, guys, so let's see. Should we do gel or hairspray? What are we thinking? What are we feeling? I think I'm going to spray it with some hairspray around. And then we're gonna smooth it out. So it's real lumpy and we don't want that. I'm Now we're gonna take our scrunchie.
I wanna get it like really high up on my head. So it looks like a little water fountain. Okay, that's what we're going for. That's the look we're going for. Water fountain inspired.
We have the ponytail.
So I'm gonna take just a little piece of hair from the back. Spray it with a little hairspray. And then I'm gonna wrap it around the scrunchie because I don't want the black scrunchie to show. And sadly, that's all I had was a black scrunchie. So we're gonna try to cover it as best as we can. That was pretty easy. So sadly, I do only have black bobby pins, but we're gonna pin it in the back and I think it won't show, so it's not a big deal. We're just gonna pin that little strand of hair in the back. I'm gonna spray it one more time at the base. So hopefully it'll stay put, but okay. I think it looks really cute when it's like split down the middle. Oh my gosh, it like came together really cute in the end, guys. We really did that, oh shit. Okay, sweetie inspired hairstyle. So this is the final look, you guys. Oh my god, I'm actually in love. I'm actually shook. This is the look, the little half updo. Look at that. Oh my god, we really did that. So cute, bitch. Okay, I'm gonna take my makeup off camera and I'll come right back and show you guys the final look for real. Okay, babies, here is the final look. I think it's so cute. I'm obsessed. Okay, so the outfit is a little bit much. I'm gonna show you guys in the mirror. Okay, so I know this outfit is not gonna be for everybody because there's a lot going on. So I do have the camo little, it's like a tiny little romper. And this is from Fashion Nova, which I got like years ago. And then I have this like Ed Hardy, really amazing zip up hoodie. It has like the little rhinestone decals in the front and in the back. So it looks like this in the bag, and I really love like the oversized fit. I just threw on this Rockaway bag, which is green as well. I don't know what it is, but I love wearing green with blonde hair. I just think they look so good together. Like blonde hair with green is just so cute. It's just such a look. And then on the feet, I have my Rick Owens, which I literally wear with every single outfit, and I've just been obsessed with these. And then I just threw on some little like DG sunglasses, which you can get on my website. I'm gonna restock my website, guys. I think my next drop will be like mid-August, so maybe like right after this video drops, I'm gonna drop on my website. So stay tuned for that, guys. I do have a drop coming for right before back to school, so don't worry. But yeah, this is the fit. Super cute, I love. Okay guys, so let's get into this hair. I'm absolutely in love. I think it looks so cute. The look really came together in the end. Like at first it was like kind of struggling a little bit, but I really like it. So I was able to like kind of just like finesse my way into like hiding the lace because it just didn't really fit my head right. But I think we made it work. I did burn my forehead. Wait, let me see if there's a mark. Oh no, I don't think so. But I did burn my forehead in the process. I was like, dang. It's still really super duper soft. It took the color very well once I toned it. So it's not that like yellowish blonde anymore. It's like this really beautiful kind of like ashy blonde. Okay, let me try to get better lighting, y'all. Because I want you to like really see this color. So do you guys see how it's like ashy blonde? It's like almost like platinum, like just like a tint of gray. So it's not like a pure platinum blonde, it's kind of like a gray ashy blonde, but I really love it. It's so cute. This is my new fave. It took the color very well. Honestly, this hair gets 10 out of 10 for me. So I did get the 20 inches, which comes down to like my lower back. Almost like it's like barely touching my butt, if you guys can see. I know the back of my head probably looks crazy because I didn't really straighten it that well, but as long as it looks cute from the front, I don't care. Here is my sweetie inspired hairstyle. I'm really loving it. I'm just out here taking pictures, sending it to my side hoes and shit, so I'm like, ah, I'm looking cute. I wish I had somewhere to go. I have nowhere to go today, so I'm probably just gonna stay home and take pictures. Shout out to V-Show Hair. All the hair details will be down below in the description. Shout out to them for sponsoring this video. I hope you guys enjoyed, and let me know if you try this look out for yourselves. Thank you so much for watching this video. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to your girl. I love you guys so, so much. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram and on TikTok, and I will catch you guys in the next one.